The next thing I knew, they got out of the car. I wished her a speedy recovery, asked how she was. At least she could have said thank you, right? But she didn't say anything. She went inside without looking at me in the face.
You know, she just got home from the hospital. She must be so exhausted.
Come on, Samuel. I just wanted her to say thank you. Is that so hard? It's easy. Come on. That's what I call courteous.
We can visit her tomorrow and square this away.
Okay, then we will. You know my name is Fikriye, my dear. I am very, very forgiving. I'm no Denise, that's for sure.
Why are you so obsessed with her? You're always complaining about that poor woman.
Poor woman? Denise is a poor woman?
She's looking so gaunt as of late. God knows what things she has experienced, which has made her so weak.
Do you really think she's so slim because she's so sad? Is that it? Samuel, you don't know famous people? In order to be slim, they're always hungry in order to resemble those models. You know what I mean. It is not because of her sadness.
I can't discuss this with you any longer.
Samuel, listen. Don't think everybody's as naive as you are. I've worked for people like Denise. I know every detail about them. I know what those kind of people really are like.
And
I don't think you should trust Denise. I'm not wrong about these things. I mean, still waters run deep, if you know what I mean. Come on.
You are really something, let me tell you.
I hope I never have to tell you I told you so, but I am never wrong about these kinds of things, dear. Watch my words. There's something mysterious about this woman. Sooner or later, everything always comes to light. Understand? And this case is no different, believe me.
Oh, listen to you. You are always talking about Denise. What on earth did she possibly do to you?
Listen, it is not my problem what happens to Miss Denise. I'm just worried for Selma, that's all.
And why would you be worried about her?
I can't believe you're asking me. All I'm saying is things are weird. I just can't ignore it. I look out my window, yeah, and it's in my face every day. There's a young girl in there with a married woman who just came out of a hospital, and Murat's acting strangely. Believe me, I feel for Murat. He must be going crazy about now. Believe what I am saying. Things can all of a sudden crash and rub off. That's what's next, and nothing but ruins in that household, and that's how it goes.
Sophie Kriye, are you at all interested in Murat, dear? You were in love with him when you were both younger.
Of course not, Samuel. A crush. How can you even suggest that? Silly. Those days are long over for me and far behind me as well.
Where is your husband these days? He's gone and hasn't come back.
I hope he never comes back, Samuel. Oh, come on now.
Don't say such things. He drives around all day, God forbid something happens.
Well, it's because of him I've suffered so much, Samuel.
I know he's a grumpy man, but a good man. We know everything about him, my dear. He's better than we give him credit for.
I wish he were a stranger, then maybe he'd value me. I have suffered so much because of him, his gambling and his drinking habits.
So he still gambles and drinks alcohol, does he?
If he stopped, maybe we could have bought an apartment here. Something of our own.
Don't talk like that. He's still your child's father, sweetheart.
You're right about that, Samuel. You are. You are. An ox is a useful animal, isn't it? It carries the load. But what about my husband? He's nothing but a bear on his 2 feet. He's not useful. He's harmful. Fikriye, my dear, please open. Good morning, and how goes it, Selma?
Good morning to you, Fikriye.
Well, can I ask you something? I was just watering the flowers in the balcony, and I saw Murat and Denise. They got in the car. So, is Denise ill again? Were they going to the hospital? I just wanted to ask because maybe you needed something. I don't know.
I don't know, Fikriye. I mean, they left without saying anything.
Oh, I see, I see. What's going on? Why are you looking so sad right now?
Not a thing.
Look at me, Selma. I'm sure that you are not fine. I know people very well. You understand me? It is clear that you have a problem. You're like my daughter, and I'm like your mother. If you don't tell me, we cannot find a solution. Come here. Come on. Come, come. Now tell me what happened. Why are you so sad? Huh?
Well, I'm not happy because of this woman and her family.
Why is that? What are they doing?
Well, if Mirat hears, he'll put me on the front porch.
Look, I won't tell anyone anything. I promise you that. I never go back on my promises. I have a reputation to uphold. Did Denise do something to you?
The thing is, they're getting so close to Mirat.
How close?
Close. Mirat is very interested in her. He even takes the garbage bin from her to throw away. For example, he went out yesterday night. I waited for him to come home.
And?
I saw that the two of them were talking, him and Denise, in the garden by themselves. I attempted to ask him what they were doing, but Mirat scolded me. He told me not to interfere.
Goodness gracious. This is really something. I suspected this myself. I knew it, dear. Selma, you wouldn't lie to me, would you? You mean well. Do you think that there is something between them?
No, of course. God forbid that would be true. You know men and how they are. I'm just afraid. Who knows what could happen, you know?
You're right about that. You cannot trust men, and you never will. He does whatever he wants and leaves you alone with your baby. Then, of course, you should go back to your father's house, and he washes his hands of everything.
Maybe true.
You shouldn't worry. But God did give us a mind to protect ourselves, so we should protect ourselves. I'll support you from now on. Your problem is my problem, and that's the way it will be.
Thank you so much, Fikriye.
Thank you as well.
Could you tell me, where are the shops here?
Well, this is what they call the Bako Center. There are tons of shops. What are you looking for?
There's a certain shop. How could I find it over there?
Okay, so look, go down there. You know Nariman's sister's hairdresser. You should go past that shop and, you know what? Let's go together. I'll accompany you.
Oh, no. No, thanks. I have so many things to do. I'll be a while. You can just tell me and I'll go alone. Yeah.
Okay, then, past the haberdashery store.